I was having a discussion with someone yesterday and they asked me that why aren't we as excited as we were for Euro or maybe for World Cup next year as we should be for the Olympics at football, which are going to start from July 22, just 10 or 12 days later. And that got me thinking that Olympics, Summer Olympics, is supposed to be a very huge event in all the categories that there are in Olympics. Then why am I not excited about Olympics at football? The thing is that, first of all, I didn't know the eligibility criteria, I didn't know the rules behind it, I didn't know anything about whatever and however and what happens in football at Olympics. So I thought I have to research about it, and that's what I did, and I'm here with all the answers that you need to know about this football at Olympics. Let's not waste any more time because it's going to be very exciting. Let's get into the video now. First of all, football at Olympics is not FIFA's official event, so they have restricted from its elite players to participate in it so that the limelight from Euros, from World Cup does not fade away. That's why Men's World Cup is the most viewed tournament in the whole damn world. Let's talk about its history. It was founded in 1900, and guess what? Till 1984 LA Games, only amateur players under 23 years of age were allowed to participate. Imagine, only amateur players under 23 years of age. But IOC, the International Olympic Committee, was not going to sit quietly on this. So they said that we are going to allow professional players too. Now listen, FIFA did not want that. FIFA wanted to avoid competition with World Cup. They wanted World Cup to be the most elite kind of tournament ever. So they reached a compromise. Any country that is not affiliated with UEFA and South American Football Confederation, they are allowed to field their strongest teams. But remember, the age limit is still under 23 years. But they restricted the countries that were affiliated with UEFA and South American Football Confederation to field players who did not participate in World Cup. Because come on, FIFA knew that all the countries are going to field strongest of their players in World Cup. So any players who did not play in World Cup, they were allowed to participate from the countries that were in UEFA or South American Football Confederation. Since 1992 Barcelona Games, competitors have been required to be under 23 years of age, with up to 3 players who are at least 23. But guess what? Since 1996 Atlanta Games, 3 overage players are allowed in the team. So you can have all under 23 players, but 3 overage players can be allowed to participate in Summer Olympics. Now listen to this, since it's Tokyo 2020 Olympics and were supposed to be held last year, but because of coronavirus pandemic, it could not be. So now in this Tokyo 2020 Olympics, players who are 24 years of age are also allowed. So in these Olympics, the players who are born on or after January 1, 1997, they are allowed to participate in these Olympics, plus 3 overage players. Now let's talk about some static facts. Number of teams are 16. And the squad of 22 players is selected. But guess what? In earlier Olympics, the squad of only 18 players was selected. But because of coronavirus, they have increased the limit, and now the squad of 22 players is selected. The current champions is Brazil. They won in 2016 Rio Olympics, and that is their first ever title. And the final match was with Germany, which ended in a draw 1-1. And Brazil ended up winning on penalties by 5-4. Most successful teams in Olympics have been Hungary plus Great Britain. They both have won 3 titles each. Guess what? The fastest goal in men's Olympic football match is in 14 seconds and happened in a semi-final match in 2016 against Honduras and was scored by Neymar. Like I mentioned before, that Olympics is not on FIFA's official calendar, so clubs are not really required to release their players. It all depends on the clubs. If they want to release their players, they can, or else not. In 2016, Olympics was held in Brazil, and Brazil really wanted to win this competition, which is why Neymar was the overage player in Brazil's squad who was allowed to participate in it by Barcelona. So Neymar played in this and they won that. They won their first ever title against Germany, like I said. Now let's talk about the countries. India managed to reach 4th place in 1956. Netherlands has won 3 bronze medals, and the last medal that they won, the bronze medal, was back in 1920. Some of the countries that have won gold medal in Olympics are Belgium, Spain, France, Italy, and Brazil. And also Argentina has won it twice. Argentina won in 2004 and 2008 and Messi has won this gold medal. Let's talk about 2020 Olympics and men's football squad. In New Zealand squad, two overage players that they are fielding. One of them is Chris Wood, who is a striker of Burnley, and the other one is West Ham's defender, and that is Winston Reid. Now for Egypt's team, Mo Salah wanted to participate but the club did not allow, and so the Egyptian king is not participating in it. Listen to Spain's squad. Their overage players are Real Madrid's duo, that is Dani Ceballos and Marco Asensio, and also Mikel Oyarzabal, Pedri, Dani Olmo, Eric Garcia, Pau Torres, Unai Simon. Imagine the squad, the Spain squad. In Ivory Coast squad, there are two Manchester United players. One is Amad Diallo and the other one is Eric Bailly. Now let's talk about the format of the competition. There are 16 teams and there are 4 groups each, means 4 teams in every group. It's a round robin tournament and top 2 teams in every group, they will qualify for the next stage. Then is knockout stage, then quarterfinals, semi-finals, and then there is gold and bronze matches. The groups are, Group A has Japan, South Africa, Mexico and France. Group B has New Zealand, Korea Republic, Honduras, Romania. Group C has Egypt, Spain, Argentina, Australia. And Group D has Brazil, Germany, Ivory Coast and Saudi Arabia. Imagine in Group C there is Spain and Argentina. That will be a match to watch. This is all about football at the Summer Olympics, and it was so exciting to research about this because seriously, I did not have a lot of idea about what happens in football at Summer Olympics. And I'm happy that I researched about it because it cleared a lot of doubts. Please comment below if I forgot to mention anything about football at Summer Olympics. I would really love that. Anyhow, that is it from me today. Please like, subscribe, share and hit that bell icon so that you don't miss any of my videos. Thank you for watching. Namaste.